Blessings to you, beloved, as I welcome you back to the Way of Salvation program for us to learn something new on this channel of the salvation. I have been talking about demons and deception. And in the last episode, I looked at some of their teachings that will make people go wrong. And today I want us to look at another thing, that demons are letting their people teach to rob people of their blessings. And one of the things I want us to look at today is about tithing. Demons and deceptive teachings. And today I want us to look at one of the demonic teachings. It's about tithing. By the way, I've written a book about tithing. You'll get to hear of it soon and read it and get more information. So I want us to understand that they are teaching many ignorant people that tithing is wrong. So today I want us to look at it from the Word of God. If you talk about tithing, a very good Christian knows that it is in Malachi chapter 3. That is where God alerted Israel concerning tithing very much. It was in the latter times of the days of the Israel in exile. And after that, the Lord said they should bring all the tithes. So we'll be looking at Malachi chapter 3. Verses 6 to 12. Verse 6 says, I am the Lord, I do not change. Verse 6 of Malachi chapter 3 says that God does not change. The God that we serve does not change. So his dealings with people may vary, but the core dealings do not change. He remains the same. Now verse 7 also says that, yet from the days of your fathers, you have gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. Return to me and I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. You see, but you said, in what way shall we return? Verse 7 is talking about Israel, talking about God's people who have gone away from him. And he, as the unchanging God, was telling them, was reminding them to come back to him. And the people were asking in what way that they can return to the Lord. So you can see that the unchanging God is saying that his people have been separated from him, so they should come back to him. That is verse 7. I'm trying to do some analysis for you to understand tithing very well. Now, verse 1 also says that, behold, I send my messenger, and he will prepare the way before me. You see? And then he says, and the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant in whom you delight. Behold, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. Malachi chapter 3 verse 1 says that God is going to send his messenger to prepare the way of the Lord. And when he prepares that way, the people who have been moved away from God, that messenger will prepare them to get them closer to God, to get them back to God again. Let me summarize it again. The unchanging God said his people have been separated from him, so he will send a messenger to prepare the way that will cause them to come back to him. So I believe you got the picture now. Now, that is coming back to do something that he expects of his people. And what was it? He says, we should come back and do an ordinance. And then the ordinance is tidy. He says, we should come back. His people should come back to him and do something. Verse 1 also says that, according to what I read in Malachi chapter 3, verse 1, you can see that tithing is a covenant. He wants us to come back to him and honor him with our tithes and offerings. By the way, let me pause here to chip in that tithing goes with offerings. In his dealings with humanity, in his dealings with his people, we always come before him with our tithes and offerings. So I don't see why you make a problem of the tithing and stop the offering. The tithing and only do the offering. Why? Because the offering comes from your heart. They often talk about tithing because that one has restrictions. Tithing actually means the tenth. When we hear the word tithe, it means tenth. So God was telling his people, still telling his people, that when we have earnings, we should bring back one tenth. That is the word tithe, the tenth. Okay. Tithing is a covenant, as I said. And this point has been corroborated by some people who died, went to heaven, and God was telling them that when we tithe, it reminds God of his covenant between him and his people. As I read from Malachi chapter 3, verse 1. Tithing is a covenant. So you can understand. God, he said, Malachi 3, 1, says, even the messenger of the covenant. You see? So God will send someone who will bring his message to make the covenant tight. So understand that when he sends his servant, he wants us to be tithing so that the covenant will become complete. Okay. In verse 8, let's go to Malachi chapter 3, verse 8. This is what God said. Because of the separation, because of the ordinance that the people were not doing. Listen to what God said. He says, will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me. But you say, in what way have we robbed you? God was saying that the people separated from him through the ordinance of tithing were robbing him. Now, verse 9 also says that. He says, you are cursed with a curse. Verse 8 says, mankind is robbing him. Verse 9 says, his people. People are cursed with a curse because we have robbed him of the tithes and offerings. Together. That's what he was talking about. If tithing is wrong, then offering will also be wrong too. But they go together. Okay, so that was what God was saying. So he said, people were not honoring that part. What he was saying is that, if I bless you, bring a tenth of it to show appreciation. It is just an act of appreciation. And God said his people should show that to him anytime he blesses us. You see? So if God blesses you and he says just one tenth should be brought back as a way of appreciation, I don't see why you make a big deal of it. So understand that one. I'm building the message slowly. You can get my point very soon. So God said in verse 10 that he said we should bring all the tithes. Verse 10, he says, bring all the tithes into the storehouse. Bring all. So So it means if you decide to pay tithe, then you do it well. You bring up, not half of it. So God said, bring up. And when he says, bring up, let me continue to read verse 10. He says, that there may be food in my storehouse. And try me now in this. God said, his people should try him with tithing. After you come back, try him with tithing. Now when we try him with tithing, let us hear some of the effects that can happen. One of them I've just mentioned in verse 10. I'm going through the effects or the advantages. He says, number one, there will be enough food in the storehouse. Enough food. Very good advantage. Storage facility will be full. Two, I will open the windows of heaven. Windows of heaven will open. Three, he will rebuke the devourer for your sake for a fruitful land. The last one, he says, all nations will call you blessed. So four things are there. Enough food, windows of heaven open, rebuke the devourer for your sake, for a fertile ground, then for all nations will call you blessed. Now, from this analysis, I want to ask you some questions. Number one, has God abolished that we should not do anything for him in return for blessing? Has he abolished that? The answer is no. It is still in the Bible that God expects his people to show appreciation, to have an attitude of gratitude for the things he does for us. We should appreciate what he does for us. So that is the first question. He has not abolished in the New Testament. If you say it was an Old Testament ordinance, I want you to understand that even in the New Testament, God still expects his people to do something in return for his blessing. The second question is this. If giving to God in return for blessing is still applicable in the New Testament, then why would you advocate that people should stop? Why? Because God expects his people to do something for him to bless us. So if you say we should stop that, I don't know what you are driving at. That's the next thing I want to ask. Now, this question I've been asking all the time. when you pay tithe, when someone pays tithe, when God said we should bring it as a way of reconciliation, as a way of making the covenant complete, who gets the blessing? When you pay the tithe, who gets blessing? Is it the pastor? Is it me or you? Is it the church people or the pastor? You answer it yourself. It is the church people. It is the one who paid the tithe who will get blessed. So what is the big deal? If you pay something and listen to all the benefits, you get enough food in the storehouse, open the windows of heaven, rebuild the devourer for your sake, for a fruitful land, and all nations will call you blessed. Who gets the benefit? It's you. So why the hula balloon? It's you. You see? Is it the pastor or the church member? No, it's the church member. So understand. If it brings blessings to the person who is paying, and you don't want him to pay, that is what I'm driving at. It means, number one, you don't understand what God meant. That do something for me to bless you. You don't understand. Throughout the Bible, all the people God blessed did something. All the time. You have to do something for God to bless you. That has not stopped. So I don't see why that side should be stopped, because it has to do with money. I've always said, if you want to see people's characters, bring the issue of money, then you see how they respond. You see? So It is always in the word of God that people should do something for him to bless his people. That is what I'm talking about. So if you are going around telling, teaching and telling people not to pay tithe, then you are robbing them of this blessing. You don't want them to get the blessing in times of tithing. Eh? I don't understand why if I will pay tithe and I will be blessed, and you go around saying I shouldn't pay. You don't understand. You don't even understand what you're saying. It does not make sense. If you tell somebody that you do something, God will bless you. Don't do it. You don't even understand. It's either you are a demonic person or you don't understand. Some of the people who advocate that tithing is passed are also people who are jealous. They are jealous because they think all the money is going to the pastor. That's why they speak like that. It is a way of generating income. It is another way for making the storehouse full and blessing his people. That is the meaning. That is the total meaning of tithing. If you say it's not true, I am a living testimony. I have paid tithe and I have seen the blessing that came on my life. I am a blessed person because of that. When people give me gifts, I also pay tithe on them. You see, I pay tithe on the income I get. So you have to understand that I speaking and preaching to you now, I am a testimony that tithing works. It works. Now, my church people can also testify. Action Power people can testify that when they pay tithe, they were blessed. I have people who pay tithe and they are enormously blessed. So that argument doesn't hold at all. And that is very interesting. What I want us to consider what the Lord said, that we should try him in this. Some people have not even tried. Eh? I know the church that makes noise about tithing. These are the people who are saying even healing is past. There are people who don't understand God's dealings with his people. You see, if you think some certain things have passed, you have your opinion not to believe it. If you say, I don't believe in tithing, it's your own cup of tea. But it is wrong and it's demonic. Demons are people who want to deprive people of the blessings of God. That is why they let their false people teach like that. But if you are truly of God, you will not deprive anybody anything that will bring him a blessing. So understand, I am a living testimony according to this word. My church people bear testimonies. A lot of people I've taught have serious testimonies about tithing. So try and see if it doesn't work. God's word is the truth. It is the covenant of God. It is the blessings of God that he wants us to take. Nothing more. If you pay tithe, you will not get HIV tomorrow that you advocate that people should not pay. If they pay tithe, they will not die. It is blessings they will get. So I don't see any point except that it is demons that have captivated your mind for you to teach people wrongly. They don't want people to be blessed. But please, a child of God listening to me, stay blessed. Don't listen to demons and their deceptive teachings. Do what will bring you blessing. And the next day, you can testify that whatever is in the word of God, if you do it correctly, you can get the associate blessings. I don't want you to go to hell. I keep telling you. I love you. I want you to live holy and stay away from demonic deception. We will learn some new things next time. God bless you. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.